gentle viewer. I'd like to welcome you to Educated Bowlers. This is our first show.
It is.
University, as do these fellows here. Welcome to Educated Bowlers. Dr. Tim Bame, a farmer, and also teaches English. Dr. Lupe Solis is a fisherman, and also teaches at Southwest State University. Now, none of the opinions that... Oh, and this is Ichiro. The possum does not teach at Southwest State yet.
Something. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the Heisenberg uncertainty. That appears to be true. You know? And again, that just seems to be right. You know, I mean, they seem to be able to actually apply it. You know, even if they're applying it for just science, you know, it seems to be true.
Well, here's a funny thing. Mm-hmm. Sometimes when I'm listening to songs, I like to think of them as though they were written by Jeffrey Dahmer.
Drugs are bad. I mean, I found that out when I found Jesus.
Drugs are bad.
When I found Jesus, I understood that.
He was so fucked up. By the time you found him, you were like, no way am I going down that road.
Well, that led to my first marriage. I mean, if she wouldn't have married me, I would have fucking died. Well, wow. The only reason that I asked her to marry me was I was like,
save your life.
Exactly. Exactly.
You're on life support.
It was. I mean, that's yeah. Crazy to say, but you know, but she brought God into my life, and now that I have God in my life, I don't, you know, so, I don't do drugs, and even this beer here is like non-alcoholic.
Make this into a Hooters.
Yeah.
Can I say that we will all be there on porno night?
Oh yeah.
We used to.
An effort to make me uncomfortable.
You guys used to be like office neighbors.
Yeah. I was thinking.
Did he ever like whip it out?
Now that you say it, typically talks about it on university property when we're away from school.
Camera shaking is me laughing my ass off. All right, so.
But the real question is, is Joe's dick somehow representative of SSU?
And they were talking about.
I bet they get together and make popcorn.
No, the obvious thing that's going on here, I never talk about my penis. I never have talked about my penis. Bicey thinks about my penis. So, you know, he thinks about it a lot, and so he brought up this thing, you know, like, your penis is this or that, and he was just trying to get me to talk about my penis and so that he could go home and fucking whack off. Whatever he does, you know. Verb to noun to verb to noun, all
see
that.
See examples of that every day, but
yeah. Mm-hmm. You think it's, like, easy, but take some Thorazine. You'll see. At every time of the week, it seems nowadays.
Law and Order.
Yeah, Law and Order, special victims, this or that. You've got on every channel stories about people who are murdering one another, eating one another, raping one another, on every level. And this is regular programming. This is allowed on. What is Marshall going to try to ban? Going to try to ban a show where some guys are sitting at the bowling alley talking. You follow me?
Yeah.
Some guys sitting at the bowling alley talking, and they say some wrong syllables, and we're going to ban this? But nobody wants to judge the situation's wrongness on whether it's wrong or not. They want to just come up with some kind of arbitrary rules which say it's wrong. It's not wrong if I say, oh, she's a really pretty cunt or something, or I love your cunt or something. It's not wrong. It's not wrong.
Were they talking about the AIDS on Good Times?
No, that was Good Times predated the AIDS.
What's that scab behind your ear?
I don't have a scab behind my ear.
I'm fighting terrorism by informing people that abortion is in fact legal.
On the station at 8:30.
Fuck up, bitch.
You know, hatless are the favorites of hell. You know, without hats. You know, favorites of heaven. I don't know, for some reason I just always view the favorites of heaven as kind of being, you know, bareheaded, or at least...
Baby, I can't make it without you, and I know.
I'm telling you, honey, you're my reason for laughing, for crying, for living, and for dying.
What do you think, your bowling career, do you think you're, like, at the top or the bottom?
I could be in the middle.
Are you a top middle or a bottom?
I'm a middle, yeah.
You're a middle.
Yeah, I'm a middle.
Turn the Virgin Mary out.
That's a fucking drool.
Go back.
Anyway, so that's the mailbag. I also got a much shorter email.
For us.
Dear guys,
all right, I'm ready. I'm about to ask you.
I feel so easy.
Okay, if you could choose to have not been born,
I feel terrible.
Would you choose
to be prepared? You just have to be prepared.
Why?
Because a long life.
You have no life.
Your fucking ass.
You like owing other people?
Yeah.
You love owing.
Bill, you're in the Nordic. Bullshit. Pain and bullshit. Yeah.
Pain and bullshit.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. That's what we got in store. Pain and bullshit.
Right.
He says he loved life. He would choose to be born because he loves pain and bullshit. Where are you going to go to college?
I'm not sure yet. I'm looking around.
You know, there's a college right over there up the street.
Yeah, I applied at SSU and didn't get accepted.
Damn. Why? I can't believe that. Why are they rejecting people?
I have no idea.
Maybe you have to know somebody.
Maybe.
Well, it's not really a story. It's a fact. It's a fact. God, you know, I have a relationship with God. God, I opened myself up to God. He talks to me. And he told me something which surprised me, but I'm going to tell it to you. He told me about the Immaculate Conception, you know, how this happened. He told me about it. He said, you know what happened was Mary, who was like a Palestinian woman, anyway, he saw this woman Mary, and it was the first woman ever, he told me, in his life, who he saw her as, and it was like absolutely so sexy, like the absolute perfect ass.
I can't think of anything interesting to say. I'm sorry.
Does freedom mean nothing to you?
No, it means something to me. It's just,
maybe it means too much.
Yes, it encapsulated in something like a soundbite.